Hi guys, follow me on Instagram to never ever miss any of my crazy updates. Hi guys and welcome to another vlog. I am riding whatever you call it, this the Bajaj Compact 4S CNG. This is the key of the vehicle and straight away let's quickly look at this vehicle. Now I'll tell you what is the big highlight on this vehicle. It's actually the indicators. The indicators positioning is such that they do not break so easily. They're not jutting out of the body. Well, that's a good thing. It gets twin lights and the lights are decent at night, not really very powerful as such. Bajaj RE written here. Front mudguard, you can see the suspension here as well. Now it doesn't get a disc brake, but these tires are 8-inch tires. These are Euro grip tires. That's a mud flap. So I'll just show you the tires from the other side as well. These are steel wheels on offer on this vehicle. The body is okay, it kind of robust. However, the roof is not really weatherproof because obviously it doesn't get any doors as such. It's compact, the size isn't very big. This being a three-wheeler isn't very safe even in terms of maneuverability or high-speed stability, but of course it doesn't do high speed as such. Now this is of course the tail light. Now the tail lights are made in a way that water does not seep inside. Otherwise, that was a problem with older ones, or rather the older variants of this rickshaw. And of course, mud flaps there. You can see that is the exhaust. And over there, again, you have the Euro grip tires. Same size tires at the front, but two tires at the rear, which is like a thumbs up. It's a safety feature here. And of course, I mean, there is no window, but there is a sort of a transparent area so that it gives in the airy feeling inside the cabin. Now let's quickly open the engine bay, which means I have to turn it like this. Open it from here. Now they've given the safety mechanism because if this thing fails, at least the boot will not open all the time. So let's quickly open that. Now it takes some time to open, so hold on with me guys. Now this is the engine bay of the vehicle. Now of course I will tell you more about the engine while driving or whatever you call it, this particular rickshaw. But yes, the engine bay is kind of compact, but the engine itself is so small, you can put a bigger engine. Actually, a bigger engine actually comes with this vehicle, double the size with the diesel. We'll talk about that in a bit. So let me at least close this right away. And of course, the good thing about this vehicle is it's very economic to run. Now this is the CNG. It really returns great mileage as well. You can see compact 4S written here, CNG written there. And we've closed that as well. So from the side, it is kind of compact. The rear seat doesn't get any headrest, neither does the front seat, but there's space to keep stuff here in the parcel shelf, and there's not much knee room or leg room on offer. So once I get inside, let me tell you, the under thigh support is extremely poor. There's no under thigh support as such. My under thigh is actually floating in the air. Leg room and knee room is also poor, and three people are a tight fit inside the cabin. In the second row, this is best suited for two people because otherwise you're going to rub your shoulders. Now there's a handle to hold on to everywhere, in fact at the front as well, while corner you can hold on to and corner really fast. And there is good amount of headroom on offer for a person of my height. Now you can see this cloth actually brings in the heat when you touch it. It is hot as well. So not really very safe as such, but most of these vehicles come up with a bar here, which is known as a Japanese technique of preventing errors by actually not letting them happen in the first place. So there's this bar, so you can't get off from here. That is a cool touch, not there on this particular rickshaw. But you do get a fire extinguisher here in case there's any fire because of rear engine and rear wheel drive, of course. Now this is the rider's driver's seat, whatever you want to call it, and of course there are plenty of amenities here. There's a bottle holder here, and this seat actually opens. Below this is the battery and the spare wheel of the vehicle. I thought I could keep stuff, but no, that is not going to happen. Meanwhile, this is to get into reverse. Yeah, that's right, to get into reverse. Now there is a cubby hole here. Again, it's lockable because of course the vehicle is open. Now this is a decent sized cup holder or a cubby hole, I would say. Why would I put cups there? It's stupid. Meanwhile, let's quickly get to the other side. I have a lot to show you. The mirrors don't really give a good view of what's behind though. I mean, they have to be manually adjusted. And we have another cubby hole here, which again has to be opened. So yeah, it's kind of flimsy, but this is smaller than the one on the other side. Meanwhile, okay, this is not going to close. There's a 12 volt charging socket here. This is the choke button. This is the speedometer along with the odometer. And over here, obviously, we get the fuel meter, and it will tell you exactly how much fuel is there with reserve. And telltale lights also place. It also tells you the battery level. So this is actually the brake fluid on offer. Yeah, you can see how much brake fluid is there in real time. This is the handbrake of the vehicle, and there are a lot of fuses. Now there are buttons here. This is to go from petrol to CNG, and this is to turn on the hazard light, and this is a dummy button. It really doesn't work. It doesn't do anything at all. Now this is actually the kickstarter of the vehicle. Now it's not a kickstarter, it's a hand starter because you have to keep pulling. Legroom is decent at the front, could have been better. Plenty of buttons here. This is for the wiper, this is obviously for the lights, and this is for the horn. Meanwhile, this is for high beam, low beam, and this is for the indicator. I will show that to you. This is the clutch, and this is the gear selector of this vehicle. Now there is a cubby hole here where I can keep stuff like that. Yeah, actually it's probably for your phone while riding. You can actually navigate properly, but my phone won't fit, so I don't know how that works. Meanwhile, there's not much on offer as such, but this is a rickshaw and it doesn't really have to have much on offer. So let's quickly get inside right away. So right now I am inside this rickshaw. So let me turn it on. This is where the key goes, and guess what? I can obviously go for a hand start or a kick start, so which means that I have to keep pulling it like this. Yeah, that doesn't really work. I am not so experienced with pulling it. I think this is disabled right now. I don't know, it's not working. So let's turn on the vehicle right away. Yeah, the vehicle is turned on. There are no seat belts on offer, and let me quickly use the wiper and show it to you. This is the wiper of the vehicle. Wiper works decently well, but there is no spray on offer here. The horn is also decent. This is the light, high beam, low beam, and of course these are the indicators. This is the hazard light switch, which I already told you about. Now if I want to get into reverse gear, what do I do? Firstly, I pull this up, yeah, to activate reverse gear. Now this reverse gear is active. Now I need to put it into first. We are into first, get into the throttle, and we are going reverse. All right, we are going reverse. There is no front brake on offer. This brake actually operates both the front as well as the rear brake. Now in order to disable the reverse, I need to put this down. Firstly, I need to get into neutral. Now we are into neutral, and I press this and I get down. Now we are into forward, and of course clutch, into first gear, revving the motor with the brakes, and off we go. Yeah, there we go. Good amount of punch into second gear. Oh my goodness, I think I'm going to topple any moment. I mean, there is not much stability on offer, but this is off-road, and of course you can really turn quickly in this vehicle, so it does offer good amount of feel and feedback because the handlebar is so freaking responsive. You turn and it turns really very, very, very fast indeed. But I think I should change the camera angle, because I think this auto rickshaw is very wide. Revving the motor, and we are off. Good amount of punch, but the gearing is very short. Okay, now we are into second gear, and there's decent amount of punch from this motor. Obviously there is a lot of wind noise, and we are chasing the best. This is powered by a 200cc single cylinder engine. Now when I say 200, it's not really 200, it is 198.88cc. The brakes don't really offer sure footed stopping power, but as I get into the throttle, let me tell you that you have to really go through the gears fast. It's a 4-speed gearbox, not the slickest of shifts, but there's good amount of punch on offer, and this particular CNG variant produces 14.5 Nm of torque at as low as 3,500 RPM. Meanwhile, output is 8.7. Now somehow I always hit the neutral, because shifting the gears is not the easiest task on offer here. Of course, slowing down into first gear, getting onto the throttle, into second gear, there is such good punch lower down, but then it kind of loses punch very fast, and obviously maneuverability is great, but the ride quality isn't great. It shakes a lot. It really shakes a lot. This vehicle weighs 388 kgs, has a gradability of 15%. Brakes are sure-footed actually, as long as you don't go high speed. I'm riding at 40 kilometers per hour. Now let me show you the real USP of this auto rickshaw. Good engine braking on offer. Now we use the indicator to make a U-turn. Now you see how easy it's going to take a U-turn. Okay, that is how easy it is to take a U-turn. I mean, it is like, it has absolutely zero turning radius. Okay, now we are into second, turning of the indicators. So really good amount of punch on offer. Into third gear, come on, yeah, gearbox, please respond properly. So like I was telling you, this particular vehicle is a 4-stroke. There's a 2-stroke available as well in LPG and CNG, as well as petrol variants, and obviously producing lesser power and torque. Now this being the 4-stroke is available with LPG, CNG. This one is the CNG particularly, and there is a diesel as well. The diesel uses a 470cc engine, produces more torque at 24 Newton meters. But the power output is lesser than the petrol. The petrol has the most power output as well as the torque output. The LPG has slightly lesser, and the CNG has the least. Like I told you already, that this 198.8cc motor produces roughly around 14.5 Nm of torque and 8.7 horsepower. And it has a top speed of around 55 km per hour. Now we are into fourth gear. Okay, in-gear acceleration is great. Handling is really poor. You move it like this and it really shakes a lot. And we are doing, oh my god, we are doing 60 kilometers per hour, which is good amount of punch. Honestly, yes, okay. This is what we auto rickshaw guys can do. Meanwhile, acha kahin jana jana, bolo 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 bolo, kar wakar. 50 mein wakar, 50. All right, jokes aside, come on, brake stop. Into third gear, onto the gas. And there is just such good amount of punch lower down. But you know, the engine really dies out fast because it doesn't rev beyond a point. I mean, it is very, very limited in terms of rev range. All right, now we're going to take a U-turn. I'll show you how easy it's to take a U-turn. Now we are into first gear already. This is a very frugal engine. Now we are in first gear. Yeah, we are in first gear. Now we are in second gear. Speed breaker, not an issue. Gradability of 15%. This good amount of space to take a U-turn here. So I just give the indicator for a U-turn. I am all set to take a U-turn. And here we are. Now the real USP of auto rickshaws is that they can turn anywhere, anytime, anyhow, without even blinking an eyelid. Yeah, NVH isn't the best. It sounds like an auto rickshaw. This vehicle actually sounds like a KTM. Oh god, that was a bad joke. KTM owners are going to be butthurt, but I'm a KTM owner and I am butthurt about the same. Handling is poor. You kind of feel every time you turn hard and fast, you are going to topple. That's the level of handling on offer. But this vehicle costs rupees 1.7 lakh rupees. And it offers a lot of peace of mind because 65 lakh vehicles have been sold. It's easy to service and of course it's a very reliable machine as well. And most importantly, it returns a mileage of more than 50 kilometers per kg of CNG, making this auto rickshaw a very frugal vehicle indeed. So guys, this is my review of the Bajaj Compact 4S, a vehicle which I feel has huge potential because you can earn a lot of money while riding it. So here we go. You can see, I mean, now I'm in first gear. Okay, ride quality isn't great. It is actually very poor. And as I get hard on the throttle, off-roading, not an issue. It does well off-road as well. It kind of shakes a lot. And when I'm turning, I have to make all my prayers because there's this sense of toppling. It can topple any given moment. But hey, this is a go-kart track right here. Ride quality is very poor on such road because of the small wheels. But honestly, this is about, you know, last mile connectivity. It's so easy to maneuver, park, and very frugal as well, which makes this auto rickshaw a great bet for those who want to. Okay, this is not for personal buyers. These are not for private buyers that you're talking so much about, you know, great bet and stuff like that. This is purely commercial. So guys, this is my review and I hope you liked it. And if you did, you know what you have to do. Okay, I know all of you are telling me only one thing. So here we will do it. Here on this particular pitch, I am standing into first gear, indicators off, okay, revving the motor and off we go. First gear, okay, I always miss the gear. First gear, it does almost 20 kilometers per hour, but guys, honestly, it is so much fun riding an auto rickshaw. It's so maneuverable and it's kind of risky as well because you never know when it's going to topple. It has this tendency of giving over feedback because you flip it like this and it's just going to turn. It just turns so freaking fast. Always, that is the case. But you know what, if you could get your knee down, you can get some amount of traction with your knee pad and of course corner better in this vehicle. I'm having a lot of fun and of course doing these donuts. This is not donuts, okay, rear engine rear wheel drive for the win. This is like a supercar on three wheels. Stop laughing, you might just stumble. Oh my god, where am I going? Okay, kidding. Okay, everything seems under control. A tachometer would have been a nice touch as well. Wandering at this speed, you are absolute nuts. Okay guys, I hope you liked the video. Give the thumbs up. Bye-bye. Oh, relax, nothing happened. Chalo chalte. And brake down. This is the handbrake, by the way. Choke button. First gear and chalo. चलते हैं, क्या सीन क्या है. आगरा 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 चलने का किसी को आगरा चलना. अरे अकेला खड़ा है, इसे पूछ रहा है जाने के लिए. चुपचाप आने का बोल. पैदल आदमी
खाली हो?
खाली नहीं हूँ. बोलो ना क्या चाहिए.
आगरा चलोगे?
आगरा हाँ चलूँगा. मीटर के हिसाब से नहीं, लेकिन
मीटर के हिसाब से चलो ना. बाजू में तो है.
200 लगेगा. 200
मीटर के हिसाब से चलो.
अरे 200 में चलो यार.
चलो चलो मीटर के हिसाब से चलो. सब मीटर के हिसाब से ही चलते हैं.
250 में चलूँगा लेकिन शेड रहेगा.
नहीं नहीं 250 ज्यादा हो जाएगा.
अरे यार कोई मिल रहा है ऑटो इधर?
नहीं ऑटो तो नहीं मिल रहा.
नहीं मिल रहा ना.
चलो ना मीटर के हिसाब से चलो.
नहीं नहीं 250 के नीचे नहीं जाने वाले. चलना तो बोलो जल्दी. 250 में चलेगा?
चलो
चलो रुक. 200 में चलूंगा. 200 में
भैया पहले डिसाइड कर लो आप कितने में.
200 में जाऊंगा. 250 रुपए तू मेरे को कैश दे. 50 रुपए पेटी तू रहने दे यार. आ जाते हैं पता नहीं किधर से. क्या बोल क्या हुआ? 100 में चल. आजा चल.
चलो
वो क्या है ना, मेरा मीटर ही नहीं है यार, चोरी हो गया रात को.
आपने बिल कैसे दो?
बिल की क्या जरूरत है? आगरा 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 चलेगा आगरा. अरे 50 में. अरे 50 रुपए में. अरे 20 में लेके जाता हूँ. अरे 20 में.
सौ ले रहे हो आप, उनको 20 में लेके जा रहे हो.
अरे तुम आओ ना 50 में. अरे आओ ना प्लीज. 50 में चल. 20 में मैं तुम्हें 20 रुपए दूंगा. आ जाओ चलो. आ गया पैसे निकाल. चल आगरा आ गया पैसे दे.
पैसे आपको पेटीएम किया ना?
घंटा पेटीएम मेरे को कैश दे, कैश
कैश नहीं है पेटीएम की आपको
अभी देना, चल जे
पेटीएम किया ना आपको,
नहीं मेरे को कैश
दे, मेरे को वापस छोड़ दो आप,
वाप चल बैठ, चलना है चलना है, अभी बता रहा हूँ 20 रुपये में फाइनल, 20 रुपये फाइनल,
अरे नहीं चलना भैया,
अरे चलो ना यार,
पुलिस को बुला दो, परेशान
करो, उनको भी लेकर आओ, चलो 20 रुपये में सबको सबको, तीन पैसेंजर, अरे यार चौथा आदमी मेरे बाजू में बैठेगा, हाँ चलो बैठो, तुम लोग भी ना यार पैसेंजर लोग, पैसे के मामले क्या मच करते हो यार,
अरे आपको पेटीएम तो किया ना मैंने,
चला गए थे कोई, इधर से उठाया था, निकल यहाँ से अभी, चल मेरे को फालतू में राउंड करवाया, आगरा 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 चलेगा,
आप जाओ